Champions Tour player, Rob. Can I call you that, Rob? That Champions Tour player.
Yeah, I like that.
I could say that. Yeah.
Got a nice ring.
Got a beautiful little ring.
Yeah.
Champions Tour player Rob Labritz. All right, Rob. So you touched on this earlier. You're clearly, I mean, you're 50 now. You're clearly at the peak of your game. You're like a fine. You're like a bottle of wine. It's just getting better as you age, right? Do you think, honestly, I want you to be honest, that these guys like Langer, McCarron, are their knees going to be shaking a little bit when you step out there? Or what?
Coming for their money a little bit?
Yeah, are you coming for their money or what?
You know, I don't think they're going to be shaking at all. I think they're going to go do their thing like they always do, and I'm going to go in there and do my thing. And you know, I'm not trying to beat them. I'm trying to play the best golf that I can.
Sure.
And if I can play the best golf, then I know that I'll whatever happens will happen. You know, it's not about going out there and beating these guys. I mean, obviously it is, but you're not looking at it that way.
Yeah.
And I want everybody to play good, because you know what happens? Your game gets elevated when you play with better players.
Right.
So I you know, and I'm not trying to cop out of this answer. That's how I truly feel, honestly. And you know, that's the way it is.
Yeah. But, we rib a little bit, but it's spoken like a true professional, and there's a reason why you're where you are. Mm. So and I love that. I mean, we even say that on our level. We feel it when we go out and play with people who are just a little bit better than us. We see things, and we see things that we might not have thought of, approaches of way to play a shot, whatever it may be. So it's really cool and interesting to hear that it works that way all the way at the top. You're just constantly getting better by playing with better golfers and great golfers. And I love hearing that. It's kind of refreshing in a lot of ways.
Yeah, you definitely don't want to be intimidated, and I'm not scared to ask questions. You know, I've played with a lot of top players, and I've probably asked a lot of dumb questions, and they probably looked at me like what is this? But they've answered my questions, and you know, I've learned from it, which has helped me become a better player and just understand this next chapter. I mean, listen, I go from being a club pro from 31 years to, I mean, I spent a year or two on the Canadian tour, but going to like traveling every week, it's going to be. You know, I'm going to have to get used to all this, how much to play, how much to practice, you know, my workouts, you know, food, sleep. I've got a lot of ideas and things, but it's going to be definitely an adaptation.
Oh, I can imagine. You know? And there's a lot of camaraderie from what we know on that tour. We had Scott McCarron on the podcast a couple months ago.
Right after he won.
Yeah. And he was talking about some of the just the vibe on it and the camaraderie between the guys. And he says some of the, just even the rounds that they play on like Tuesdays, he was telling us how much fun that they have out there. So, I'm sure that'll be great for you, but what, you know, so let's get into that. Like talking about changing life a little bit and touring, like what now, like what kind of goes into picking what events you're going to play and just kind of balancing that life of coaching, practicing, traveling, family life. I mean, it is a big shift. So how do you plan to attack that?
Yeah, that's a great question. And that's the question that I've been spending most of my time, you know, sitting here trying to figure out. You know, the way I look at it is I've been given an opportunity to play in all these events. So I've got to manage my time, and I've got to manage my you know, my body, so to speak, and make sure that I'm rested. I mean, that seems to be the biggest thing. And obviously staying away from getting sick, because we don't want that to happen either. But, you know, I signed up for the first three events. I'm going to see how 3 weeks play out. Then I'll have a week off after that. And then after that, I believe is the Trophy Hassan, which is in Morocco. Which, you know, we'll see where the COVID, where it ends up there. I mean, if I can travel freely and feel good and not have to quarantine and all that stuff, I mean, I'll probably go play that. And then if not, I'll have another week of rest. And the weeks of rest will be nice, because I'll be here with my family at Glen Arbor, New York. And also, you know, at the club, which for me, it's a fabric in me. I just love being there. I love talking about the culture of the club and changes on the golf course, and you know, just hiring great people. That's just me. So on my weeks off, I'm going to come back and do that. For me, that's refreshing. You know, some people like to fish, some people, and I like to do that stuff too. But just to kind of grab my normalcy at the club, you know, teach a few lessons. I'm sure I'll have some good things to teach some people, and then you know, kind of go out on the tour and. You know, just try to find that flow and that rhythm of working out and practicing and doing pro-ams and eating and resting. And I mean, I think that's the magic formula. You know, when I'm at home, going to the club is relaxing for me. It's not, we don't have, it's not a demanding club. It runs itself. It's a great place to come and forget about your problems or whatever you're doing for a while, you know, and play some golf. So it's, we just try to provide the best service we can, which is, you know, it's part of me. It's part of who I am. So that's how I'm going to do it. And then we're going to make alterations, you know, on top of that and just see how it's working. I don't think there's any magic pill. I think there's a lot of people out there probably say, I can't do both. He can't do both. But you know what? I've been told I couldn't do both since the beginning of time. Right. And you know what? I got a chance to do both now, which is kind of cool. So, you know, we'll see where it leads. I know the PGA classification changes, I guess. PGA America told me in February when I peg it up in that first event, I moved from an A4 director of golf to an A3 tour player. So that makes me ineligible for the National Club Pro Championship, which will, you know, probably make me ineligible for the PGA Championship unless I win the Senior PGA Championship and get into the PGA Championship that way.
Gotcha. So, okay.
Hey, well, there's still a path. There's still a path.
There you go. So you're telling me there's a chance.
Listen, all Rob needs is a path, and he'll get there. That's incredible.
That is great.
So that's cool to be able to still maintain, you know, at the club, because Glen Arbor, it's just a terrific club. We've had our limited exposure the couple times we've been there. We've just been absolutely impressed. Most recently getting fit at the we're just showing on screen a picture of us with the 19th hole, which
there
is
back there. Yep.
As fun a shot as it gets, but even getting to do our fitting there at your training and practice facility, you just have a state of the art, absolute top notch facility. Mm. So certainly don't blame you for wanting to keep your hat hung over there as long as possible. But the other big piece of that, family is the other big piece of that, you know. Mm-hmm. So I know we started mentioning a little bit earlier, a big part of even helping to get here is having that support of family, no doubt about it. And I want to hear you talk a little bit about that. But then there's no doubt there is the difficulties that come with travel. We feel it ourselves. Both Mike and I both have young daughters ourselves. And every time we travel for golf, which is, you know, limited comparison to what you've got ahead of you, it can be difficult to leave. So what's been the family's take and response there?
So, you know, we've planned for this and we've always talked about it. And now we think about it logically. I mean, we have, my son is 18, he's at LSU. So, you know, he's kind of on his own, right? Sort of. Mm-hmm. And then I have an 8-year-old daughter who's in third grade. And then an 11-month-old daughter who's not in school yet. So we're going to just let Ryan finish out her third grade. You know, I'll probably travel alone at that point. And then once Ryan finishes school, then the family's going to come out on tour with me.
Oh, that's
awesome. So they get to experience this as well. So it's going to be a family thing. We've been waiting for this I love spending time with them. So it's going to be a home run.
Great. What an incredible way to A, spend that kind of quality time with family and B, use it as, I mean, something that not many kids get is to get to see, you know, the country and see the world in that way. I think in a lot of ways it's something that you're giving them that they just, it's such a unique experience. Oh, yeah. I think that's incredible. You had,
hopefully it will rounds them out a little bit more, you know, definitely travel will.
Yeah, for sure. I mean, just those experiences and experiencing different places and things like that. Again, it's something that a lot of us don't even get to do in a lifetime, let alone in our childhood. And your son, he mentioned he plays as well, and you won the Massachusetts Open Golf Championship with him on the bag, right? So he's been involved in your journey a bit.
Yeah, we won the Massachusetts Open, the Westchester Open, and the Rhode Island Open all together. He's caddied for me 4 times. And we made it through the pre-qualifier for the, it was one of the ones down in Florida, one of the PGA Tour ones. I don't remember, like the Doral or Honda or something, together when he was on the bag. So we have this great little camaraderie out there. I don't know. He kind of brings out the best in me. I actually joked with him. I said, hey, listen, you want to forego college for a year and come out on tour with me? No, I'm just kidding.
It's like a Stuart Sink family story right there.
I know, right?
Yeah, cool.
We have a lot of fun together. He loves being out there. He's a good golfer. I wish he loved it a little more like me, but it's okay because he can play the game. He can break 80. And he's got a beautiful golf swing, good touch around the greens. I'm like, oh man, just wanted a little more, but anyway, right. It is what it is. So
yeah, that's great.
Still incredible. Yeah.